Hey, Tyrese. Ready to go to your new digs? Your absolute mansion? Your gorgeous home? Tyrese, my Fajaca Puffer's 180-gallon aquarium is up and ready to go. Even have the filter on it, but we've got to do a couple of things. I drained the water slightly because we're gonna take his tank water and add it to here so that when this, when I add in the biological media, it's not like it's just surviving off of stale water. We do want a little bit of ammonia, nitrites, and nitrates in it. Hopefully there's some in that water, although it's very doubtful. With that said, I gotta feed some of the fish. And before I do that, I actually have a bone to pick with a few of you guys, you see. I've been reading your comments. We'll get to that. Piranha first. Tank's looking beautiful, isn't it? Working on a few aquariums lately, and a few of them are looking really good, but of course, all in preparation to build this really big tank. And that build, well, maybe we'll touch base on that today. Man, this tank's always fun to watch. This guy goes nuts. Now it looks like there's 30 piranha in there, doesn't it? They're getting big too, eh? This tank just gets better and better with time. The plants become lusher, the piranha get bigger. Everything's just maturing beautifully. And look at all the piranha just in perfect shape. Absolutely gorgeous. You got one up here too, guys. That one got air bubbles on it. It's floating around. Wonder if they'll notice. Yeah, there you go. They're to the size where one of them can eat an entire piece of shrimp by themselves, which is really cool. Oh, I've actually already fed the baby stingrays. I actually fed them earlier. Tons of reflection on this tank right now. It's difficult to feed to film it, but look at all the Ultim Angels, the Geophagus, everybody's out. You know what? They kind of look like they still might eat something. This pearl's got a big old fat belly on them, or her, and this one does as well. There's the black diamond up there. He's quite active, but he's really small and not growing as fast as the pearls, but that's relatively normal for black diamonds. I really got to fix this tank. Look, everything just fell over once it, once the wood fully saturated, once the plants lost all the bubbles on it, they just kind of fell. I don't see much of a belly on the black diamond, so I think I'm going to add a little bit more food into here. Well, we'll do the 2000 first. Give them all something to eat. 2000 is looking probably in its worst state, but the fish are absolutely gorgeous. Keep in mind, we're also going to be kind of rescaping this tank, and a lot of the, why do you look like that? Look at that severum all barred up. That is breeding dress. Wait a minute, what's going on, you two? That's a male. They're both males. Are they fighting over the female over here? Is that eggs on the back of that rock? What's going on in here? See how he's all barred up? That's breeding dress. There's that new Oscar. Some of my old ones. Gorgeous Asian arowana, eh? If you don't remember, we're going to put this big wooden tree structure in the middle, put in substrate and have rocks, and I'm thinking maybe even some plants in here. It's gonna look awesome. Anyways, notice how the gallery is cleaned up. It's not looking like a pigsty or disgusting or gross or I don't know. What other comments did you say? Joey, you really got to take care of the gallery better. You got to do this better. You got to do that better. Obviously, I do. I got to admit, it can be difficult to create videos, take care of the fish. The fish, of course, are priority. And then I had a bunch of other stuff going on outside of YouTube. And the gallery and tidying it up and, you know, it just kind of took the back seat, of course, but it is what it is. You guys know that I'm personally not going anywhere. Sometimes we make lots of videos and sometimes we make very little, but I gotta say, now that things are tidied up, I've got a tremendous amount of videos that I gotta make. You're probably noticing right now that there's been a few back to back or at least every couple of days, and I'm gonna try to keep doing that because there's just too many things that I gotta do. That's that. So for the little rays, I chop it up finely minced. So you could feed that seafood diet to any fish, technically, so long as you kind of like chop it up finely for their mouths. This might even be too much, but we'll see. I throw it in there, and for the zero amount of fish that are in there, there's no fish clearly, obviously, right? They're all hiding. This tank went from all kinds of fish in it to there's none. I don't think these pearls will eat it, but the geophagus are going to come back around. The black diamond starting to get a little hungry. This tank is very dimly lit in person, so the camera's trying to overcompensate. Maybe I'll give you an idea of what it actually looks like. It's more so like this. So it's actually quite dark, but this is going to be the Electric Eels Aquarium. See if the black diamond comes out. Yeah, he's coming. He's not a huge fan of this. He prefers pellets, believe it or not. Come and get it. Hurry up. Come on, you're almost there. Jeez, bro. Took forever. Yeah, so let him go nuts on that. A little bit of clams, mussels, chopped up market shrimp, etc. Get him nice and plump. Hopefully he actually eats it. Looks like he's blowing it out from underneath of him, but yeah, could be a texture thing for him. I'll offer him pellets later. Anyways, we could probably give this to the salt tank. Are they eating it? Probably should have chopped it up a little bit finer, but they'll eat it. It's weird because sometimes it looks like there's no fish in here, and then other times they all come out at once. And the reason being is they all hide amongst the plants and as well as the branches. Like even if you look at the front branches here, you can notice that there's so many cave systems and there's so many places for fish in here. I will say one thing. Well, let me preface it with something else. Apparently you guys are taking bets on how long this racking system will last. Some people said 10 days, 2 months, etc. After I build this tank here, the 700, this a 17 foot long tank probably, the 2000, the 375 will all be permanent fixtures. And the only things that I can kind of tinker with are the 180s and maybe this. But I have specific plans that are going to take a year to come to fruition. So we'll talk about this later because there's already fish in it. Anyways, whatever's left in the food. Do I have anybody else I gotta feed out here? Oh, we should go feed the electric eel. Yeah, it just kind of sucks. One of my coolest fish is down or in the house. But isn't he active? He seems to enjoy it. He'll be fine in the 375. In fact, he's gonna love that. Let's get him something to eat. Gosh, be careful. Please don't come out of the tank and get me. You really legitimately got to be careful with this guy. Or he's a very hyper and excited eater. And I'm always worried he's going to jump out of the tank and get me. It's cool though, eh? I'm not looking forward to netting him because it's going to be so much more difficult to do. But he'll be far more appreciated out in the gallery as well as have more water volume. He'll have access to what? Almost 3,000 gallons of water dilution in a 375 gallon tank that's 8 feet long, 3 feet wide. It's perfect for him. A 180 would probably do an electric eel for like 5 years or so though. But I'd rather have him outside because he's like one of the most active electric eels I've ever seen. I think most people would agree. Like this guy is hyperactive. For an electric eel, a lot of the times they just lay there. Maybe that comes with size, but I've never seen one that's 3 feet long that does this. Well, it just turns out I have the best electric eel in the world. Beautiful. Gallery does look a lot better cleaned up, doesn't it? Obviously not clean. I'm going to repaint the floors. We're going to repaint all the walls. I don't know if I'm going to do that once I move all this, but once we get Tyrese out of his aquarium and him over there, I can take this tank off, the filter off, everything out of here. And then I think I'm going to do the stand or I'll just paint the walls next. I don't know. Or I'll move on to this system and finish that up. I just feel like I got too many projects on the go that I'm leaving things like half done. So it is what it is though. Hope he does well in this tank though, because that'd be nice. It looks to me like Tamara's getting a couple 40-gallon tanks to replace some of her 15s, and she's getting this tank. She's going to go with bigger, more tanks that are simply bigger. Less tanks, but technically more water volume and easier for her to take care of. I think we've overwhelmed her and expected too much out of a literally a brand new hobbyist, so I also wanted to keep making videos because they're really entertaining to watch, really fun to watch. Different spin on fish keeping. Why isn't the water draining out of this?
No, that's draining.
That's filled. I got all the air out of here, but it's not going over the lip.
So what do we gotta do here?
That's filled with air, water. Oh, I see now. I don't know if you guys can see it. See the water now it's coming? I just gotta raise the bubble above the outlet and keep it going. But that was enough to stop it. No, it still won't go on its own.
I'll start you outside. How's that sound?
Not enough gravity pulling it is all. It's going now. Which is weird because this tank is several feet lower. Whatever. So we're gonna put some of Tyrese's water in here and then top it off with fresh. It'll also make catching him a little bit easier as well. This filter's not going, but the filter media is. So while that's draining, we're gonna unplug this. We're gonna look at the filter. Oh, you'll remember, I already got one of them. I got this from Temu. Remember, look at all my salt creep. This is the worst part about saltwater tanks, but when you have a tremendous amount of flow and water splashing and whatnot, that's what can happen. Anyways, water enters from the pump below. It gets pumped up into here, and there is a drip plate in here that I need to clean that filter floss. Cheap filter floss, just pull it out. Water sprayed over it. It goes through here, and I just have sponge in here because all of this is considered a dry area. It's not submerged, so you would have wet, dry. And then this part here is filled with biological media, like ceramic media, and it's all submerged underwater. This one is just up on the 2000 for now because I need to build it a stand, but I set it up the other day. I figured you guys probably don't want to see me set this up again, but essentially, we're gonna have to kind of take it apart. Top part off, and the middle part, actually I have nothing in there right now. I'll fix that. We're going to take it out of here. And now the sponge is in this. I'm not gonna clean it because I need to use this filter on something else. And I want the filter, the sponges to stay cycled with biological, bacteria. Although I don't need water in it. I actually ordered a bunch of like dirt cheap biological media and mechanical media for filters because it's like one of the most expensive things in the hobby that we need, but a lot of it is all the same thing. It's just overpriced. And they all make all these crazy marketing claims, which really bug me. Like I seen one that was like, it's literally compressed sand and they claim it does everything. Ammonia, nitrate. It also takes care of nitrogen gases and oh man, it just does everything, which obviously is more so marketing hype. And I wrote about this in my book, Infiltration. I'll bring it up. You guys like to get these like little free shots, but it's not just the do-it-yourself book on how to build absolutely everything in the hobby. It's more so understanding things. And my favorite chapter, if you've gotten the book, is on filtration. Chapter 5. So that chapter focuses on know your bacteria, types of filtration media, how much is really needed, flow rates and sizing, and then we build the filters. So page 166. So bacteria is, of course, an organism that lives on a surface. It does not care what it grows on. It's just based off the conditions. And look at the stuff we talk about. Like I was like a little scientist. pH matters, temperature matters. The light penetrating the media matters. What it's made out of doesn't matter. So I'll probably do an unboxing and do some testing on some of this stuff. You guys want to see that, let me know. Well, I'm going to do it anyways because, well, I think it'll be useful for a lot of people. And I kind of miss testing things. So, but yeah, we all depend on beneficial bacteria, Nitrosomonas, Nitrobacter, for the freshwater hobby. I have a question for you guys though. Would a fish do better in certain conditions than others? The simple answer is yes, and so does bacteria. So can you have stronger, more efficient bacteria than me? Yeah, but it also depends on the filtration and the conditions of the aquarium, the method of filtration, the state the media is in, whether it's fluidized, submerged, emerged, all of that stuff. But again, I talk about that in my book, and I don't talk about my book enough. What we got here? All right. So we're gonna take all of this. I could have swore about 10, 15 years ago, these were bigger. And now look how hollow they are.
But that's the case with everything. I remember when a bag of chips was like full to the top.
Now it's 50% air, 50% chips.
Looks good, eh?
Filled to the top, keep it away from the outputs. This, it's not completely filled right now, but once the water starts flowing, water will rise a little bit and start overflowing out of these
and returned to the aquarium there in the back.
I don't think this is final placement. I think it's kind of an eyesore and annoying, but it's super easily accessible. Both of these tanks are getting the same filter. So I might just build some sort of platform here. But I also have a ton of canister filters, but there's nothing I have holds this much media. I was gonna build these, and then after pricing them, I started getting ad after ad after ad from Temu, and apparently a lot of other YouTubers have used Temu and stuff like that. So I checked it out, I saw these, I was like, $60? Yep. Ordered three of them so far. Now you would think, why not clean the sponges real quick? I want these to be nasty because they're going on a tank and I'm going to put in some more biological media when it arrives. But I want those sponges, those filthy, filthy sponges to kind of jumpstart it. Ooh, look who's out. Mr. Sunshine. And a tiny little Severum over there. I don't even feel like he's gonna care that his girl is gone. Cause we're moving her to this racking system at the bottom with Tamara's flower horn and seeing if they'll breed. I think it's the next video or so that we'll talk about this. Maybe on Sunday. Yeah, on Sunday, I gotta finish filming this tonight. And mind you,
watch what time it is. I've just been busy. Throughout the day, I don't have time. Look how concerned Luke is. Daddy, you should get in the house. It's 2:30 in the morning. It's not 2:30 in the afternoon. It's 2:30 in the morning. This is my only time when everybody leaves me alone.
I also knew that I had audio issues a little while ago. And many of you guys brought that up, like, Joey could barely hear you, or there's so many crackling. I've been trying to film and haven't been doing quality checking or making sure audio works. And by the time I find out that the audio is all messed up, and it might even be messed up now, it's too late. The video's already filmed and I put it out anyway. And I think that over the last couple of years, it's kind of been like that for me, rushing the videos, doing too much and that sort of thing. But I'm getting back into the groove of the way things were. I'm telling you right now, don't go anywhere.
But aren't these a cool size tank? 60 gallons, four feet long. Doesn't look it. 16 inches wide, 16 inches tall. All of these are. Oh, the beginnings of the planted tank are started. There's another tank with our fish already in it. And this one's not ready, but we haven't really done a lot of updates. I think another video that I'm gonna do is completely on this, cleaning it, taking care of it, feeding them. But I must admit, I have an idea for a fish and I'll leave it for that video. I also can't wait for this to be done. Once this is done, this will compete with the piranha tank. I'm not sure how much I like Tyrese's tank anymore. And I think it's because of all the Anubias. I think I want it off of there. Let me know what you guys think. Is this tank great? What should I take things out? Should I take everything out and just have the background and some substrate? Because Tyrese technically doesn't need all that. It's cool though. I like it. Somebody said Tyrese is in the closet. Kind of. But I like it and he's gonna like it. I guarantee you right now, Garen goddamn tee it, that he's gonna spend all of his time right here watching us. And it's such a cool angle.
Of course, once we paint this black, it'll look a lot better. I'll be honest with you, I had a paintbrush and I left it out overnight, and now it's just hard as a rock and I have no paint thinner, so I just gotta pick up another paintbrush and then I can paint it again. All right, Tyrese, ready to go, bro? That's an 8-inch net.
Oh.
It's an 8-inch net, and he's at least 10, 11 inches. He might even bite through this. He doesn't look happy to move, but he might puff up, but it's just air. And he didn't puff up. Some people say don't move a puffer with a net, but I always do. Oh, he's like the same color as this aquarium. Enjoy it, my friend. He never gets this dark, but he was this dark just a minute ago, so maybe he's a little stressed out, or maybe he's happy. I don't know. We'll give him a little time to settle in and go from there. We'll update in one of the next videos, take a look at him, see how he's doing. But I think that'll be it for today. I'm going to continue to drain this tank. Won't keep you guys along. I'll drain this aquarium here and finish filling that tank. Turn the filter on, and that will be that. I'm also got to get this filter up and running, this tank finished, introduce you to those fish that are in it. And then, of course, what else do we got to do? Oh, and then I got to unbox all this media that came and see what's what, see if it's any good or not. If you guys want to see any of that, subscribe. Subscribe if you're not already. That's how I say it. Okay, see you in the next one. Bye.